పర్యటనలో ఉన్న మంత్రి లోకేష్ టెక్నాలజీస్ ఫర్ టుమారో సమావేశంలో మాట్లాడుతున్నారు. లైవ్ లో చూద్దాం.
So we have a state, we have a state-run project where we're taking fiber to every home on an Android TV box at the end. And we have 5 campaigns, and these campaigns are actually aimed at connecting to our citizens at large. So we've taken a life cycle approach as a state. So we've not looked at, you know, X department, Y department, but what we have taken is, you know, how do we keep the citizen at the center and serve the citizen? So if you look at it from birth, infancy, education, employment, health, housing, marriage, old age, and even death, we call it Mahaprasthanam, how do we map the entire cycle? And how do we as a state offer services? We as a state become proactive towards the citizens. It's been an amazing journey. Mr. Naidu is known for his transformative e-governance initiative. And we call it Naidu 1.0, and that was Mi Seva. But what you see today is Naidu 2.0, and where we actually have Aadhaar, which is the India's national ID, which is powered by biometrics. But we as a state flipped it, and we bought it as family as a unit. So we have a real-time census that goes in the state. We call it golden data. And we have a people survey where all this is housed. We also have land hub, where all the land records in the state are digitized. And by June this year, they're going to be on a blockchain platform, where land can be transacted like your DMAT accounts, like the shares. Anywhere you are sitting, you can buy and sell land. So that's what we're going to launch. And to end, actually, we are now sort of bringing about e-office, where the entire government is online. We transact online. Yes, as a state, we're also powered by SAP. We are the only state that has implemented SAP, our entire treasury. So this is our core dashboard. We as a state love data. And I think it sort of fits into the theme here at Davos. This is a live portal. We'll give you, we track everything. I mean, if you sneeze and cough, we pretty much track it as a state. But the exciting part here is, you know, we track even groundwater. We track groundwater on a daily basis. Because the biggest challenge as citizens of the planet, you know, we've really lost track of preserving our natural resources. We have taken it for granted. And this way we've tracked rainfall, we're tracking even groundwater to the last mile. And this data, I mean, thrown open to the entrepreneurs here, can be really transformative. They can offer services to the farmers. They can offer solutions for the complex problems that we have in India. So this dashboard is quite comprehensive, and we would share this link, and we would love input on areas that we could actually do better. You know, the success of the state is our ability to roll out programs for our citizens. This is a very, very interesting program. It's called Chandrana Bima. It's actually an insurance program for all our citizens. So anyone who dies in an accident gets close to 500,000 rupees, which is about $6,000 from the state. It's an insurance program. And natural death, they get close to about $3,000, which is massive in an Indian context. But just look at it. We've been able to settle. So, you know, if there's an unfortunate death in a village, in 15 days using data and using biometric-enabled devices, we are actually able to deliver the money to the family. On the day of the death, we're giving 5,000 rupees for the last right expenses. So it's very powerful. It's just an idea of how we're using data to really deliver services to our citizens. The other project is the public distribution system, where we're using biometrics on food security, we're using biometrics on our ration or on a pension. And the exciting part here is the citizen satisfaction. So we actually call all our citizens in 24 hours. So once you avail a service from the government, you will get a call from the state. Are you satisfied? How can we serve you better? So this is about how do you make government more proactive and not reactive. The other project that we've launched is Mukhyamantri Yuvanestam. This program is about getting unemployed youth onto a platform. And the platform is about giving a monthly benefit scheme. But then we just don't stop there. We're looking at actually working with the industry to get inputs on where things are moving. And how can we skill up our entire unemployed youth? Very powerful program launched in 12 days. An unemployed youth can just sit in their office using Aadhaar, India's unique ID. With that, they can actually access the entire portal. We triangulate data from 7 different databases, including the education department, birth and death. And this is a real-time portal. Very transparent. And in case you're not eligible for the scheme, we actually tell you why. The other project that we've done in the state is we have something called the National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme. This is a Government of India program. And this is a project that I personally lead as a minister. Using dashboards, and we're probably one of the very few states that have used dashboards, we've pretty much dashboarded everything, and we're able to monitor performance real-time and link it to the last-mile functionary. So performance of government officials up to the last mile is actually linked. And we actually look at accountability coming in. We've doubled our performance in 12 months. And this is an indication of how a simple dashboarding tool has really brought about transformation. You know, I work with close to 26 ministries in this convergence project, and it's quite effective role how technology has worked for us. You know, we also have a real-time outcome monitoring system, ROMS, and this is where we actually benchmark ourselves as a state. You know, in ease of doing business, we are number one in the country, but we're not excited about that. How can we be number one on this planet? So we're trying to learn from our peers in Singapore. We're trying to learn from other countries. How can we be better? You know, we have the Samaja Vikasam, where again, it's SDGs broken down into different ways. And we have 10 themes and 47 indicators. So we have Kutumba Vikasam. We have key performance indicators, GVA, and also the SDGs. So think about this. 961 key performance indicators monitored real-time across 36 ministries. And we have 1 million IoT devices in the field giving us data. And we have a real-time governance center which actually takes this data, does a lot of homework on it, and then advise ministers, ministries on where we're failing and how can we do better. And create an internal sense of competition among various ministries. So just to give you an idea of our journey, you know, Aadhaar, as I said, is the national ID program.